Hello traders, my name is Grigor Horvat and welcome to a new video update in which we will discuss about the euro dollar and why I think that the euro dollar has reached a top here. There are a lot of traders out there who are not sure if the euro dollar will continue lower or higher from current levels, and the reason is mainly because of this structure from this high. If we switch to the 4-hour chart, you will notice that this fall is quite overlapping and choppy, which is usually characteristics of a counter trend of a corrective price action. Okay, which means that choppy sideways price action is part of a larger trend. Okay, well. Sometimes when the price actions are not very clean, you of course must pick some different approach and use some different filters to recognize the right look of the wave pattern. Okay, so here is one trick. I usually switch to the larger time frame when the wave structure on the smaller time frame is not clear, okay, or if the structure on the larger time frame is not clear, then leave this time frame and focus on clear patterns that are on the lower time frames. Okay, so now I will switch to a daily chart, and you can see that on a daily chart actually a movement from 2012 low was in three waves, okay, which I believe is a corrective movement, an ABC. Then we also had these extensions lower over the past few weeks through this support line from 2012 low. Okay, so this is a very very important evidence that trend has changed from euro bulls to euro bears. Okay, especially because on this weekly chart, if we also take a look on this trend line, okay, the market also extended higher in three waves after a break higher through this trend line. Okay, so obviously if we were if here we turned bullish, then here we should now turn bearish, okay, for a minimum three waves of decline, because we know that in Elliott wave theory structures are usually minimum in three waves. Okay, so at least we should see a three wave move to the downside. So I think that because of this broken trend line, because of three wave rise, the euro dollar is will be headed lower. But that's not only the one thing why I believe that the euro dollar will be weakening. The next thing is that actually we still have this quite choppy price action on the 4-hour chart. Okay, but if you take a look on this daily and switch it to the line chart, okay, then the structure is much cleaner. Okay, you can see here that we have nice wave 1, wave 2, an extended wave 3, wave 4, which now here looks like a flat, and this was wave 5. So actually this very choppy and unclear price action on this bar chart, on 4-hour chart, appears to be very nice and clean impulse on this daily line chart. Okay, so I labeled the wave count for you, which is here, and you can see that actually this is a nice five wave pattern. And if we also consider that recovery from 2012 low has a corrective personality, and that we have a broken trend line connected from those lows, then of course we should consider more euro weakness, minimum in three waves. Ideally this market will fall impulsively lower, but we always must focus on one wave at the time, okay, and on minimum expectations. And minimum expectations in my case will be a free wave of decline. Okay, so that's about the euro. However, there are still chances, of course, that I'm wrong, but just to confirm my view, to be even more confident in what I'm saying, I want to check some other correlated markets. Okay, so that's the next filter that we will take a look on. So now I will take a look on German bunds. Okay, these are not the US bonds, but are of course our national long-term debt instrument. Okay, it's issued by the German government, okay, not by the US government. So these German bonds are actually have a very tight but negative correlation with the euro dollar. If German bond will rise, euro dollar will typically fall, okay, and vice versa. So actually, if I have a five wave decline, if I believe that's a five wave decline on euro dollar and that we are headed much lower from this peak, then of course German bond market should have a five wave rally, okay. So let's take a look at the structure. And here I have the German Bund. You can see that actually I have here a bar chart, okay, open, high, low, close, okay. I don't have a line chart because structure on this bar chart is very clean to me, okay. It's a five wave rally. We have wave 1, wave 2, extended wave 3, wave 4 pullback, and now wave 5. Okay, so that's a five wave rally from these lows. Okay, you can see here that German Bund market turned higher, turned bullish, actually on at the end of January. Okay, and the euro dollar turned lower. Let me see, turned lower on 1st of February. Okay. Actually, the 1st of February was the high for the euro dollar here. So actually, these markets turned lower and higher at the same times. And in fact, I can also put the overlay chart here. I will compare this bund with the euro dollar. Okay. Okay, it's euro dollar. We will switch this to line chart, and you can see here that bund has recovered at the same time when the euro dollar fell lower. Okay, so if we were unsure about the euro dollar weakness, if the euro dollar fell from this year highs in impulsive manner, or maybe it's a corrective movement because of unclarity on the 4-hour chart, as I showed you earlier, then now we have here a quite strong evidence which confirms the idea that fall on the euro dollar was impulsive, because on bond market here, as you said, we have five waves up. This was wave 1, wave 2, wave 3, wave 4, wave 5. Okay, so this confirms the idea that euro dollar should continue lower, because if the bond market will continue higher, the euro dollar will continue lower in the same manner. Okay, so actually that's not all. I will also now take a look on the larger picture of this bond market. What is the wave structure telling me for possible euro dollar direction if correlations will remain as they are? So here we have a long-term chart, and you can see that German bond market has been trading higher since April of 2011, and the most recent price action from 2012 high is actually looking corrective. Okay, this was a free wave movement, and we know that free wave patterns are corrective patterns, are contra trend movements, which means that larger trend uptrend here is still intact. Okay, but if we put this free wave decline into the full context of this price action, then we can actually, this could be a nice recognizable contracting triangle. Okay, and we know that triangles are continuation patterns. So if that's the case, okay, then we know that we need five legs in this triangle. Why five legs? Because triangles are structured by waves A, B, C, D, and E. Okay, and we can see here that this was our wave A, this was our wave B, wave C, wave D, and wave E. Okay, and always when you want to call the end of the wave pattern, you need what? You need an impulsive reaction in the direction of this larger trend. So our larger trend was higher, is up, okay? So now we need an impulsive direction to confirm a continuation of a larger trend. And we spotted a five-wave rally on this German Bund daily chart from January, from January levels, okay? We have five waves rally, so maybe the German Bund market completed contracting triangle at those levels, okay? So if that's the case, then we will see a break higher through this trend line, which will lift this Eurobond maybe towards 150. And at the same time, of course, the euro dollar should weaken. In fact, we said that we had also a free wave rally on the euro dollar from 2012 low, which is what? Also a corrective movement. And there we already have a broken trend line. So all this is saying to me that the euro will probably weaken, okay, and the German Bund market will strengthen, because simply I cannot count this as an impulsive price action to the downside, which means I cannot expect this Euro German Bund market to weaken. So I will stay with this trend, I will be looking higher, and at the same time, of course, because of the correlations, I need to look lower in the euro dollar. So now, if you were confused about this structure on the 4-hour chart because the of the overlapping price action, let me check back this 4-hour chart, okay. Here it is, because this of this overlapping structure, actually now we answered your question. Yes, euro is probably headed lower because of clear pattern on a daily chart, on a daily line chart, because of this broken trend line, because of previous free wave rise, and more importantly, because the Eurobond market has a five wave rally from the lows, and because the larger trend for the Bund market is looking bullish of this contracting triangle, which means that the euro dollar should weaken